Next question. Consider the following kinds of organisms. The name of four organisms are given. Which of the above are primary producers in the food chain of oceans? As you all know that primary producers are plants or the plant type of organisms. Now see, this is our environment book for IELTS 2021. On page number 9, we have mentioned the food chain, different types of food chain. This food chain starts with the plant. Plant converts the solar energy into the protoplasm by the photosynthesis. Here we have also given the diagram of the marine food chain, plants and the plant type of organisms such as phytoplankton. Primary producers are shown. Now see the question. Which of these organisms are the primary producers? Now again, go to our environment book for IELTS 2021, page number 151. Here we have given a list of marine biodiversity species of India, and in this list different type of species are mentioned. These are the plant type of species. These are the protozoa type of species, and these are the animal type of species. So in these plant type of species, the first one is the diatom. Therefore diatom is correct. Now see the question. Diatom is correct. It is the primary producer because it is a plant type of organism. Only option B and C contains the three, that is diatom. Now check the other ones. These are the protozoa type of organisms, not the plant type. And in these, Foraminifera is there. So it is not a plant type of species. Foraminifera, this is wrong. Now remove the 4. You are left with the option B, 2 and 3. You can also check the cyanobacteria given in our books. This is our science and technology book for IELTS Prelims 2021, page number 61. Here there is a mention of photosynthetic cyanobacteria. So it is also a plant type of organism. Cyanobacteria is correct. Diatom is correct. Therefore, B is the answer and the question is solved. Next question. Magnetite particles suspected to cause neurodegenerative problems are generated as environmental pollutants from which of the following? 5 options are given. Let's first understand what are these magnetite particles. This is our World Economic Geography book for IELTS 2021 on page number 78. There was a mention about magnetite. It is basically iron ore having the iron content of more than 70%. Therefore, and the background of this question is, this is our December 2019 current affairs book, page number 47. There was a news: heavy metals contaminating the India's river. And it shows that samples taken from 2/3 of water quality stations spanning India's major rivers show contamination by the heavy metals. And here it is mentioned the iron. Iron emerged as most common contaminant, and the long-term exposure to these leads to neurological degenerative processes. So this is the background of this question. Now check the given options. Magnetite or iron particles, they are used in the manufacturing of auto parts or motor vehicles. Therefore 1 and 2 are correct. Power plants They also release the harmful gases, so they are also considered as harmful pollutant. 4 is also correct. Microwave stoves within the homes and telephone lines, they as such do not generate a iron related pollutant. Therefore 1, 2, 4 are correct. B is the answer. Now check the explanation given in our books. This is our science and technology booklet for ICE prelims 2021, page number 166. There was a mention of iron ore, that iron ore, it is used in the manufacturing of auto parts. Similarly, in our environment book for ICE prelims 2021, page number 32, there was a mention of thermal power plants. They are responsible for emission of huge amount of gases and other pollutants. So therefore, from the given options, 1, 2, 4 are correct. B is the answer and the question is solved. Next question. Constitutional government means, 4 options are given. And the correct answer is that it means a government limited by terms of the constitution. Now this is our Indian Polity booklet, page number 57 for ICE prelims 2021. Here it is mentioned that powers and functions of the president. Constitution says that executive power of the union shall be vested in the president under Article 53. President of India shall thus be the head of the executive power of the union. And before we take up the analysis of different powers of Indian President, we should note that constitutional limitations under which he has to exercise its executive powers. So limitations are imposed by the Constitution on the government. Again, it is mentioned that Indian Constitution by its various provisions vests the following powers in the hands of President under the expression executive power, subject to certain limitations. So limitations or restrictions are imposed by the constitution itself. So therefore, D is the answer and the question is solved. Next question. Which of the following best defines the term state? 4 options are given. First is that state is a community of persons. Wrong. State is not a community of persons. State is not a number of persons. A state is not a society. A state is a politically organized people of a definite territory. Now you can best define the term state by taking India as an example. This is our Indian Polity booklet, page number 35. Article 1 of the Constitution describes India as a union of states. So the term state can be best defined by taking India as an example. And the first feature is that it should be a politically organized people. See this option. It should be a politically organized people, that is the elected members of legislative assemblies and parliament. Second is that they must belong to a definite territory. Yes, India and its states, they have a defined territory. Third is that they should possess an authority to govern. Yes, the Constitution of India, through its very elaborate provisions, give the authority to the elected members, such as ministers, prime minister, chief minister, the authority to govern, to maintain law and order, to protect the rights through the provision of fundamental rights, and to safeguard their means of sustenance through elaborate provisions under the article, directive, principles of the policy. Now see, this is our Indian Polity booklet. Everything is explained here. The Constitution of India establishes the parliamentary system. Features are the presence of nominal and real executives, majority party rule, collective responsibility of the executive to the legislature, membership of the ministers in the legislature, leadership of the Prime Minister or the Chief Minister. So these are the features of a politically organized people. This is Indian Polity, page number 31. Now see the next features, that they derive the authority from the Constitution of India. And Constitution of India says that executive power of the authority shall be vested in the President. The President is the head of the executive power of the Union. So all these elaborate provisions, they are given in the Constitution. The executive power does not only mean the execution of laws by the legislative, but also the powers to carry out the business of the government. 57, Polity Book. Next is Polity Book, page number 34. Here, the preamble secures to the citizens the liberty of thought, speech, belief, faith, worship through the provision of fundamental rights enforceable in the court of law in case of violations. It also secures the economic justice that denotes that non-discrimination of the people on the basis of economic factors, that is, it involves the elimination of glaring inequalities in wealth, income and poverty. Therefore, all these features are of a state. So the option B best defines the term state. That state is a politically organized people of a definite territory, possessing an authority to govern, maintain law and order, protect the natural rights, and safeguard their means of sustenance. Therefore, B is the answer, and the question is solved. Next question. Why there is concern about copper smelting plants? Three facts are given. Now check the first one, that it may release a lethal quantities of carbon monoxide. This statement is wrong. This is our environment booklet for ICE prelims 2021, page number 19. Here we have mentioned all the major air pollutants, and here the carbon monoxide is mentioned. Its sources are combustion of coal, oil and other fuels, and burning of biomass. Smelting is not there. So therefore this statement is wrong. Now take the third one, that this smelting, it may release sulfur dioxide as a pollutant. It is correct. Here the air pollutant sulfur dioxide is mentioned, and its sources are coal smelting for metal extraction. So smelting is there. Therefore third is right, one is wrong. Now if you remove one from the given options, you are left with a B. Three is correct. Now check the second also, if you want, that this copper slag, it causes the leaching of some heavy metals into the environment. Again, on the same book, environment book, page number 24, for ICE prelims 2021. Here it is mentioned that all types of waste is dumped in the landfills, and when the water seeps through them, it gets contaminated, and in turn it pollutes the surrounding areas. This contamination of soil and groundwater through landfill is known as leaching. And here the major type of sources and types of leaching are given: urban, industrial, domestic, rural, and in industrial. The main type of leaching is slag. Slag is the first one. Therefore, second is correct, third is correct, B is the answer, and the question is solved. Which among the following step is most likely to be taken at the time of economic recession? And the correct answer is increase in expenditure on public projects. Now see, this is our Indian Economy booklet for IAS Prelims 2021, page number 229. Here it is mentioned that there is a deliberate policy of a government to spend more than its earning, to increase the aggregate demand and to give boost to the economy. Generally, it is resorted to when the economy is in a recession. Again, on the page number 232, it is mentioned. Indian Economy Book, page number 232, here it is mentioned that a fiscal stimulus, it is a government effort to boost economic activity during the period of economic weakness. Economic stimulus is mentioned. Use of fiscal policy, government to spend more to support to revive the economy in a recession. Therefore, B is the answer and the question is solved. Question. Consider the following statements, and the statement is that other things remaining unchanged, the market demand for a good might increase if, and four options are given. If the price of its substitute increases, it is correct. If the price of its complement increases, this is wrong. If the good is an inferior good and income of the consumer increases, it is wrong. If its price falls, it is correct. Therefore, 1 and 4 is correct. Now see our Indian Economy Booklet. Indian Economy Booklet for IAS Prelims 2021, page number 234. This economic principle is clearly explained. The cross elasticity of demand. The change in the quantity demanded of one product impacting the change in the demand of another product. Example, percentage change in the quantity demanded of a good is divided by the percentage change in the price of another good or its substitute or complement. Therefore, the statement 1 is correct. Now, fourth statement is that if its price falls. This statement is also correct. Again, in our Indian Economy Book, this principle is explained. Elasticity of demand. The responsiveness of the quantity of a commodity demanded to a change in its price, expressed as the percentage change in the quantity demanded divided by the percentage change in its price. Now this is a practical example. This is our December 2020 current affairs book, page number 115. Here it is mentioned that the penetration of lithium ion batteries is projected to increase, or the demand of lithium ion batteries is projected to increase primarily due to the decreasing prices of lithium ion battery systems. Therefore, the fourth fact is also correct. 1 and 4 is correct. A is the answer and this question is solved. With regard to the Indian government bond yields, they are influenced by which of the following? And three factors are given. Let's first understand the term Indian government bonds. This is our Indian Economy Book for IAS Prelims 2021, page number 114. We have given a complete chapter on this topic. Government securities. A government security is a tradable instrument issued by the central government or state government. Such securities that are short term, they are called the treasury bills, and the securities that are long term, they are called the government bonds. So government security or the government bond, they have almost the same meaning. Now see the question again. Indian government bond yields are influenced by which of the following? Actions of the US Federal Reserve, actions of the RBI, inflation and short-term interest rate. All three factors are correct. Now check the each one by one. This is our September 2020 current affairs book, page number 49. There was a news with regard to the RBI announced special open market operations, RBI has decided to continue simultaneous purchase and sale of government securities under the open market operations. So the factor that actions of the RBI, it influences the yields, it is correct. Now in the next line it is mentioned that spike in the government security yields in the last few sessions came in the backdrop of rise in retail inflation. So inflation is also correct, actions of the RBI correct, inflation is also correct. Now this is our November 2020 current affairs book, page number 23 and 24. Here it is mentioned floating rate bonds. Here it is mentioned that the rate of interest on these bonds is linked to a benchmark rate and is reset at a regular level. These bonds pay a fixed rate of interest. Floating rate bonds, they have a variable rate of interest. And how the interest rate of RBI floating rate bonds are fixed? We have mentioned it in this news. So therefore, the short-term interest, they also influence it. 2 and 3 is correct. 2 and 3 is given in this option D. D is the answer. And first factor, that actions of the United States Federal Reserve, this factor is also correct. This is our Indian economy book, again for IS Balance 2021, page number 120. Here on this page it is mentioned that government bond yield or government security yield, it is the annual percentage rate of return earned on a security. Yield is a function of a security's purchase price and a coupon interest rate. Interest rate is mentioned here. Yield fluctuates according to the numerous factors including the global markets. So the global factors, they also affect this. Interest rate affect this, inflation affect this, and actions by the RBI affect these. So all three are correct. D is the answer and the question is solved. Next question. Consider the following statements, and five statements are given. Now check the first one, that Moringa or drumstick tree is a leguminous evergreen tree. This statement is wrong. This is our geography book for IAS Prelims 2021. On page number 46, we have given the full table of the evergreen type of forests and their species. These are the species of trees: mahogany, ebony, rosewood, ironwood, rubber, mangrove, etc., oak, eucalyptus. So all these are evergreen trees and Moringa is not there. Therefore the statement first, that Moringa is an evergreen tree, this statement is wrong. Now check the options. If you remove one from the given option, you are left with the B, 3, 4, 5. Now check these sentences, 3, 4, 5. All the sentences 3, 4, 5, they are correct. Third statement is that in India, most of the tamarind is collected as a minor forest produce. This statement is correct. Now this is our June 2020 current affairs book for IAS Prelims 2021. In page number 3, there was a news that 23 additional minor forest produce items added in the list of MSP, and here the tamarind is mentioned. So tamarind is a minor forest produce. Therefore, the statement 3 is correct. Now check the fourth statement, that India exports the tamarind and seeds of Moringa. This statement is also correct. Now see, this is our March 17 current affairs book, page number 87. There was a news that India suspends agri commodities imports from Vietnam. India has temporarily suspended the entry of these items from Vietnam. The decision comes after the Vietnam announced that it would suspend the import of these items from India, and these items include the tamarind. So India was exporting the tamarind to Vietnam at that time. So the statement 4 is also correct, that India exports the tamarind. Now check the 5th one, that seeds of moringa or tamarind can be used in the production of biofuels. This statement is also correct. Now see the tamarind. This is our current affairs book, September 2020 current affairs, for IAS Prelims 2021. On page number 94, there was a news with regard to the cotton waste converted to supercapacitor electrodes. Here it is mentioned that the scientists, they have developed a couple of cost-effective electrode material, making affordable supercapacitor devices from the waste biomass like tamarind seeds. So tamarind seeds, they are a biomass. And in our this book, Science and Technology book for IAS Prelims 2021, page number 20, on this topic, biofuels, it is mentioned that biofuels are a wide range of fuels that are derived from the biomass. So the statement 5 is also correct. Therefore, 3, 4, 5 are correct. B is the answer and this question is solved. Question. The money multiplier in an economy increases with which one of the following? And the 4 situations are given. Money multiplier increases in the economy when the banks give more loans, more credit, more advances into the economy. Now check this fact in our books. This is our synopsis of Budget and Economic Survey for IAS Prelims 2021 exam, page number 87. Here it is mentioned, money multiplier. Money multiplier, which was mostly increasing from 1980s onwards up to 2016 and 17, has however been declining since then. And why this money multiplier has been declining? Because a large amount of funds are parked in the banks. Therefore, banks are not able to lend more and the money multiplier has been decreasing. Now check these 4 options. Money multiplier in an economy increases. Take the first one. Increase in the cash reserve ratio in the bank. That is wrong. Now this is our Indian economy booklet for IAS Prelims 2021, page number 83. Here the fact is mentioned that the cash reserve ratio, when the central bank raises the CRR, it reduces the lending capacity of the commercial banks. Therefore, it does not increase the bank's capacity to lend. It is wrong. Now check the second statement, that increase in the statutory liquidity ratio in the banks. It is also wrong. This is our Indian economy booklet, again for IAS Prelims 2021 on page number 14. Statutory liquidity ratio is explained. Here it is mentioned that higher ratio, it diverts the banks from the loans and advances to other sectors such as in government and approved securities. So therefore, it is also wrong. Increase in the population of the country is also not correct. Now check the C option, by increase in the banking habit of the people. It is correct. C is correct because when the people, they save more in their bank accounts, it increases the bank's capacity to give more loans into the economy, to infuse more loans into the economy. So it increases the money multiplier in an economy. Now again check this fact. Indian economy booklet, page number 168, we have given a full chapter on the financial inclusion, that how people can save more. Here it is mentioned that financial inclusion, it drives economic growth by mobilizing the people's savings and investing these savings into the growth of other productive sectors. Therefore, C is the answer and the question is solved. Next question. Which of the following have species that can establish symbiotic relationship with other organisms. Now first check the cnidarians. This is our December 2018 current affairs book, page number 61. Here it is mentioned that jellyfish comes from one of the oldest branches of the animal family tree, that is phylum Cnidaria, which includes corals. So corals, they are a part of Cnidaria. And in September 2019 current affairs book, page number 60, here it is mentioned that corals have a symbiotic relationship with tiny marine algae. Therefore, option first, Cnidarians, it is correct. Now take the second one, fungi. This is our science and technology book for IAS Prelims 2021, page number 68. Here it is mentioned that many fungi are important as partners in symbiotic relationship with other organisms. Therefore, fungi is correct. Third is protozoa. This is our science and technology book for IAS Prelims 2021, page number 18. Here it is mentioned malaria. Malaria is a potentially life-threatening parasitic disease caused by the parasites Plasmodium vivax inside the human host, that is in symbiotic relationship with the human host. This parasite undergoes a series of changes as part of its complex life cycle, and this Plasmodium is a protozoan parasite. Therefore, protozoa is also correct. 1, 2, 3 are correct. D is the answer, and this question is solved. Question: with reference to casual workers employed in India, consider the following statements. Three statements are given. Now check the first one, that all casual workers are entitled for employees provident fund coverage. This statement is wrong. This is our Indian economy booklet for IAS Prelims 2021, page number 124. Here it is mentioned employees pension scheme. Employees pension scheme is a social security scheme run by employees provident fund organization. Eligibility: employee must have rendered eligible service of 10 years or more where contribution to EPFS has been made. All the features of the scheme are explained. Therefore, casual workers, they are not entitled. This statement is wrong. Now from the given options, if you remove one, you are left with the option B. Now check this third statement, that government can by a notification specify that establishment or industry shall pay wages only through its bank account. This statement is correct. This is our important laws and legislations PDF provided to the students of IAS Prelims 2021 course, page number 650. This is the PDF of Code of Wages 2019 Act. Here it is mentioned that appropriate government may by notification specify the industrial establishments or the employer of which shall pay every person employed in such industrial or other establishment the wages only by check or by crediting the wages in his bank account. Therefore, this statement is correct. One is wrong. 3 is correct. You are left with the option B. B is the answer, and this question is solved. Next question: which one of the following factors constitute the best safeguard of liberty in a liberal democracy? Four options are given, and the correct one is separation of powers. Now see the explanation. This is our Indian quality booklet for IAS Prelims Exam 2021, page number 42. The very first line of this chapter, Fundamental Rights, it says the same thing that is asked in the question, that the success or failure of a democracy depends largely on the extent to which the civil liberties are enjoyed by the citizens in general. And a common device that is adopted by most of the nations for this purpose is to list a fundamental rights in their constitutions and guarantee them from violation by the executive and legislative authorities. Further explanation, September 2020 Current Affairs Book, page number 214 for IAS Prelims 2021. There was a news with regard to Keshavananda Bharati. Keshavananda Bharati was the sole unwitting petitioner in the historic fundamental rights case, which prevented the nation from slipping into a totalitarian regime. The Keshavananda Bharati versus Kerala case is unique. It evolved the concept of separation of powers among the three branches of the governance, legislative, executive, and the judiciary. So this judgment, it evolved the concept of separation of powers, which saved the fundamental rights. And fundamental rights, it ultimately saved the democracy. Therefore, separation of power is the best safeguard. D is the answer, and the question is solved.